Now, to go back to sex specifically, so I'm just going to talk about spirit sex for just a minute, okay, if I may. So what happens when you have completion, right? So get to 9, 10, and each partner, and you're having what I call spirit sex. What happens in that moment is in that sexual experience, it's really magnificent because it allows each to ascend to a higher level than they could have on their own. And it is that experience of merging into the oneness. It is actual union. Like, you know, we talk about the male, female coming together in union, and however that shows up for you. It really becomes almost like a reset into the oneness. You almost, in my experience, can lose your identity in a way that's not, that sounds scary, and I don't mean not hold your space or whatever, but I mean what you think is yourself from your ego mind, from all that, and you just go into much deeper of an experience of the eternal now and an experience of this pure source energy, because you together are merging into that field. Does that make sense? From a sense of completeness.
There's almost kind of like a multiplier.
Yes,
factor to this.
Yes.
So you get, you know, these two people that are in a position where they can actually take each other to a much higher level than either one of them individually.
Yeah, because it's like a mastermind that's being formed, right? Yeah. That is of a very high order. And what's amazing is a number of things happen in that space. One is it resets you right out of your ego mind. There's no more ego. Like anything that you had going on about like cloudiness around who you think you are and how awesome you, what all, you know, all this, any kind of potential towards ego or self-aggrandizement disappears. It's like a reset into what, like to spirit, where it's really, you see things from, again, you're like clarified of like, okay, this is spirit perspective. You're in the eternal now. And it lasts for a very long time. So more than the physicalness of say like the orgasm state, it lingers because it percolates through time space in a very slow way. So it stays with each person even after the physical act is complete.
I'm almost picking up like a sense of purity.
Yes.
It is so pure.
Yes.
You know.
Yeah. And it's really, I mean, it's so difficult to explain a state where there are no words and words. I mean, it's kind of funny, right? It's like trying to explain like a taste or something. But
it's wonderful that in human bodies, we can actually attain that.
Yeah. It's awesome.
Yeah.
And it's really magnificent. And what I would say is, so that's what I call spirit sex. And then after that, what happens is, like I said, each individual is stronger than when they begin. So that is really cool. So spirit sex is spectacular. I wish it for all of you. Whatever form that takes for you. And the key to getting there is to clear enough of your own distortion patterns. So it's always back to self, in the sense of your own accountability. And then like I said, there's a lot of stuff around sexuality. It's like, the layers of distortions around sex is like crazy. It's like about that and money is just, those are the two things, right? So those things are particularly charged. So there's a lot of distortions coming through with regards to that. And the more you can move through, the more you can get to the state where you can experience this. And also the other thing I'd like to say is that, you know, in our culture right now, there's this sort of like goal-oriented sex in terms of what we write about in our magazines, you know, like, I don't know, Cosmo or whatever, they're always talking about how to orgasm in like 17 ways or less, or I don't know, whatever. But it's always this thing about the orgasm for the woman. And it's funny that becomes the goal. That's not what it's about. Ultimately, like in terms of what I talk about spirit sex, it's just about being in that moment, hyper present with each other. And then something else happens. And something else else happens. So it doesn't really, you're not really thinking, well, like, okay, well, now I, you know, I have performance anxiety or whatever it is I'm supposed to be doing that doesn't come into play.
Yeah. It's beyond.
It's beyond that because you're just simply very present with each other. Yeah. So it frees you from that, which is really wonderful.